Hello and welcome to my channel. In this infrared tutorial, we are going to transform this to this. Infrared photography is a different way to make unique landscape photos. It can be achieved by either converting your camera into an infrared camera, or you can buy an inexpensive IR filter. When making an infrared photo, you need to have your DSLR camera on a tripod stand, because the shutter speed is often 1 second or more. And before you mount the IR filter, it's a good idea to set the focus. It can be very hard to find the focus when the IR filter is mounted. So mount the filter on your DSLR camera. And don't forget to set the focus before you mount it. As we are going to take a picture over more than 5 seconds, it's a good idea to have a remote timer to not cause any shakes to the camera when making the IR photo. One other thing that's important is to set the white balance. I myself took a photo of some green grass with the IR filter mounted and then select it in the settings menu. If you want, you can also use the white balance preset values. I would recommend to use the incandescent. For this IR photo, I choose the aperture 2.8 and shutter speed 10 seconds. I set the ISO to 800. So now let's open Photoshop and start editing. Drag the IR picture into Photoshop. Increase the exposure some. Decrease the contrast to flatten out the photo some. Also tweak the shadows a bit. Flatten out the picture a bit more by adjusting the blacks. Use the white balance tool and click the grass. Now we can open the IR photo and start editing. I start by adding an adjustment levels filter and just tweak the settings a bit. The next step is to go to the channel mixer and swap the colors. We are going to swap red to blue and blue to red. If you want, you don't have to swap red to blue and so on. This is just how I prefer to make an IR photo. I prefer when there's a little bit of orange in the picture, so I don't set the red here to 100. And when you're done, just click OK. Again, I'm going back to the levels filter and I'm just going to tweak it a bit more. The IR photo right now looks too dark. After that, we're going to erase as much reds as we can, and also the magentas. I prefer when there's a little bit of orange left, so I'm going to leave it this way. So that's pretty much it. I'm just going to make some final touches and then I'm done. I hope you like this short tutorial and you find use for it. If you want, share it with your friends. Thanks for watching.